EIC and the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission earlier on today. So we're crossing over now to Safari Park. My name is Lillian Muli. We're not yet done with Citizen Extra. Up next is Swalem Doy with more news of the day.
During my time as a parliamentarian, I was very much involved in the issue of peace, not only in Kenya, but in the region. I was the chairman of Kenyan chapter of Parliamentarian Forum on Peace, which has got a name called Amani Forum. And I was there for 5 years. Honorable Speaker Kaparo was there at that particular time. He was the Speaker of Parliament. And we worked on the region to look at what are the causes of instability and insecurity in the region. And so, listening to Ambassador from Rwanda, we have had so many occasions to visit Rwanda to see for ourselves what had happened. And at the same time, during the 2007-2008 National Kenya Problem, I was a member of the ODM. And I participated. I am the key person who really stopped some of my colleagues who were overzealous in doing some unwarranted things. So it is important for us to note that one individual can contribute to peace and stability of the country. And I just want to mention two things that it is very important for us, and especially in the university or institution of higher learning, to look into critically the root causes of instability. What are the causes of instability? Is it the name, as I already said? Is it unfairness? Is it unfair distribution of resources? What are the causes of instability? What are the causes of people to get out of peaceful situation? So this is a very, very important area which the university should look critically and develop, especially our young people. And there are two things which women who are in the military academy, as people who are supposed to provide support for stability, two very important things. One is the aspirations of citizens. What do citizens aspire for? What citizens want? And the second is the expectations of citizens. What the citizen expects. And so if we base these two factors on this and bring in the issue of leadership, then we can, as a nation or as a community of nations, be able to understand and look at how we can bridge this, because people, Kenyans or citizens of the world, aspire to live in a peaceful environment, to be able to run their businesses, to be able to conduct their affairs in an uninterrupted way. That's what they expect. And they expect their governments to provide that security for them to be able to prosper, for them to be able to develop. And so that is the aspiration, the want, the need of the citizen. So people need peace. People need to conduct their businesses in the best possible environment. And so if the expectations are met, then you are going to have peace. If the aspirations are met, and if the expectation of their government or whomever is providing their security, then they will live in peace. But if that is interrupted, and then I want to suggest, Professor, that in the 21st century, we must avoid lamentation. We must avoid lamenting. We should start saying what is there, how we can tackle it. We have a habit of lamenting, of looking back. Sometimes we blame colonialism. Colonialism has gone 70 years ago, 50 years ago. This generation in this room are born after colonialism has ended. And yet, we are still going back to lament, oh, you know, it is because the Wazungus or they have done this, and it's our own mistake and our own weaknesses. So this conference is very timely because it comes at a time when we are preparing as a country for the federal election of 8th of August. With the impending general election, we are experiencing violence in places that were traditionally non-violent. Kenyans are aware that they do not have another country to run to should animosity erupt or anarchy erupt. We must all work to remain united, peaceful, cohesive, respecting our social, cultural, and political diversity. Peace building, social cohesion, and promotion of national values is about bearing hope, aspirations, and confronting fears and prejudices. We must realize that national cohesion and national values cannot be achieved single-handedly, but through cooperation and building partnership with various stakeholders. It requires the support and input of all of us. The government has put in place security system and structures to ensure that the country, its citizens, and their property are secure before, during, and after the general election. We will ensure that it's not only during the election that citizens and their property are secure, but at all times. However, it is the responsibility of all of us as Kenyans, more so political leaders across the political divide, to preach peace during electioneering period. Leadership is a key determinant in the stability of our country, and the impact of such leadership is demonstrated not only during this period, but also in the extent to which our political leaders promise to promote cohesion and peace. There are many ways of looking at the causes of peace in our country today. Peace and security are two overlapping concepts. It is not possible to think of peace without thinking of security. To protect the state from various threats, leaders must have vision on the type of the country they want. Leaders tend to have capacity to analyze core national interests and ability to defend and promote fairness in running the affairs of the state based on the Constitution. Leaders have to work constantly in order to maintain peace and stability of our country. We need to have institutions, shared values, acceptable policies, an operating system in place to guarantee peace and security. This forum, therefore, is very timely because the idea of engaging in dialogue on peaceful intervention for sustainable development in the contemporary society, especially in Kenya today, cannot be emphasized. We are aware that peace and security are vital requirements for social and economic development, as well as effective democratic governance. Therefore, the integration of peace, security and social enterprise as the agenda of discussion during this conference cannot be overemphasized. This is more so because emerging security dynamics and social economic challenges have made many of our youth vulnerable and easy targets of unlawful criminal groups that take advantage of the vulnerability and ignorance of our young people. In light of this, the creation of a social enterprise through innovation, creativity, and membership opportunity, particularly by institutions of higher learning, will promote barricade against radicalization of our youth into terrorism and other criminal activities. Social enterprise is a vital driving force in the growth of any economy. Hence, the reason behind the government of Kenya commitment towards youth empowerment in the Vision 2030. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, maintaining peace and security requires concerted effort at individual, communal, and organization levels. We appreciate the pivotal role that academics play in resolving societal trend needs. Although academics have been said to pay more attention to teaching than conducting research, this conference provides space for others to evaluate a myriad of impediments to the effective attainment of peace, security, and social enterprise in our country and the whole region. Such innovation can help address specific inhibitors to peace and security, such as social exclusion, poverty, crime, and substantial level of inequalities, among others. Additionally, research findings and recommendations can help introduce new answers to social problems where conventional approaches have not allowed solutions. I commend Mount Kenya University and their partners for making this conference possible. I am happy to note that one of the key partners of this conference is the National Cohesion Integration Commission, NCIC.